ladies and gentlemen on YouTube. It's the artist, formerly known as the Natural Born Thriller. And this video is going to be very intriguing because it pertains to The Weeknd, XO, and Republic Records. There's an album that came out. You actually already know what the album is. Don FM. So that came out back on January 7th, 2022. I didn't listen to it yet. So what I'm gonna be doing, this video will be just for a one album, reacting to it and reviewing. And I heard it before already. Yeah, you know, obviously I'm a Weeknd fan, so you know what it's all about. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm going on the road of The Weeknd's first album all the way to his fifth album. Obviously his first album from 2013. Which was released back in September 10th, 2013, called Kissland. Following that one, I'll do a separate video of that one, of the second album that came out on August 28th, 2015, Beauty Behind the Madness. Following after that will be another album, just with The Weeknd reinventing himself and evolving. Back in November 25th, 2016, Starboy. And pertains to one of my favorite albums of all time, next to Beauty Behind the Madness, that came out on March 20th, 2020, which during the lockdown, the pandemic is when it started. After Hours, which the album itself kept everyone intriguing, and the music videos and everything that The Weeknd did, which is the After Hours of him with the red suit and the black leather gloves, all the 9 yards, wherever you have you, kept us all very entertaining during that the rough time. Hope you won't go through that rough time again, because you know that's a lot of COVID still going around, unfortunately, with other viruses as well along with it. But yeah, but besides that, so I just named me now 4 albums. And pertains to January 7th, 2022, The Weeknd has been teasing this since 2021, that the dawn is coming. And it has finally come. Dawn FM. Haven't listened to it yet, other than the one song, which I already knew what was going to be that one song that was going to be in there, which was Take My Breath. Now, pertains to during the time in 2021, when The Weeknd was teasing the dawn is coming, we saw the Miss video, and we heard a song, the single. It was a single of Take My Breath. Later on, we heard an extension of it, of Take My Breath, which that is included into the Dawn FM album that he released. So, this is what we're going to be doing. Now, I'm not going to listen to the whole thing. Just to get y'all a heads up in the way it tends to, back to the first album, Kissland, where I'm going to listen to the songs, and you're gonna listen along with me. Hopefully there'll be no copyrights, no violating the YouTube protocols of copyrights and copy claims. So we'll see how that turns out. So with that being said, let's get right into it. It pertains to the first track, which is called Professional. The town. Habitation. Love in the Sky. We'll find our love in the sky. Belong to the World. Live For. Wanderlust. Kiss Land. Pretty. Tears in the Rain. Alright, so that was 10 songs from The Weeknd's first album, Kiss Land. And let me just go through Professional. Professional was the opener, the intro of all this, introduced us to Kiss Land album. And it was decent. Nothing to say about that, you know. But Professional, was 6 minutes and 8 seconds of what it can deliver the liking of Kiss Land. Following that was The Town. I thought that was alright too, lasted 5 minutes and 7 seconds of your liking if you think The Town is a pretty good song for those who are Weeknd fans. Then we had the adaptation, which was 4 minutes and 43 seconds. I thought it was better than the first two, that to be honest. The operation, I meant to say. I think I said it wrong, but first. The operation. But I thought it was decent, better than the first two that they gave us. Following that was Love in the Sky, 4 minutes and 27 seconds. This was actually pretty good, this song, which is one of the singles, obviously. So, I enjoyed this song a lot. Belong to the World. Now, I thought this song was amazing. Just the way The Weeknd just sang the song in there, he makes it feel like with him singing, the way he was singing in this track, it's like the world belongs to him, just the way he nailed it. And I love the introduction, by the way, the thunder. I think that was like the thunder, the open up the song. About 5 minutes and 7 seconds it lasted on the song, and I enjoyed it. Pretty damn good song. Following it was Live For, feature Drake, and 3 minutes and 43. 3 minutes and 42 seconds. Pretty good song. I love the song that what it was for the it gave, for this is the shit I live for, which that's what The Weeknd is all about, and Drake is also what it pertains to, of this is the shit that I live for, with the people that I die for. So pretty damn good song. I don't know if there was actually a music video. I don't think it was a music video, if I recall, but there should have been, their phone was Wanderlust, and it was 5 minutes and 6 seconds. Pretty damn good song too. I'll definitely recommend listen to the song to this again, and it really did deliver of how pertains to this album. Kissland, the name of the album, was also a name of a song for this track, and I enjoy this too. You know, do I put that as above as my all-time favorites? No, but it I enjoyed it though for what it was. Following that, Kiss Never, by the way, was a long song, the longest song on here, which was 7 minutes and 35 seconds, and I thought it was worth it. I didn't feel like I had to skip it. I didn't feel like I had to to fast forward to get to the best part. I thought Kiss Never was pretty good. Then finally it was Pretty, 6 minutes and 15 seconds lasted. I thought this was pretty good too. And no, what's another say? I thought it was a pretty good song. No point to it. And finally, all right, 6 minutes and 15 seconds it lasted. The song, 6 minutes and 15. And then we had Tears in the Rain, which was the final song of the track, of the album. 7 minutes and 24 seconds. So this was the third longest song on this own album. No, I'm sorry. Is it? No, I'm sorry. The second longest one. The third one is Pretty, but Tears in the Rain was pretty good too. I enjoyed listening to Tears in the Rain, especially if you want a close ending to the album. I think Tears in the Rain was a right fit there to end it. So what pertains to this album itself, I like the album. It's not, you know, to be, it would be one of my least favorites of the Weeknd, but it had a good some good songs there. For me, if I had to choose how many songs that took my liking of that could be the best songs for you to listen to, it would be Love in the Sky, Belong to the World, Live For, Lost, Wanderlust, Kissland, Pretty, and Tears in the Rain. Appetition, I should say. Appetition was also being the one that I recommend as well. Just listen to. But there you go. But if you ask me which one is my all time favorite in this album, my all time favorite song that I listen to, Belong to the World. This song was pretty damn good to me. I thought this song nailed it, and it was a far better song than any other songs on here. Next to it will be Live For, which tends to have a drink in there. So there you go, folks. No more to say about that. So, his first album, I will give it, as it pertains to a letter grade, I will give it a C. So, that's the best I can give for. And hey, we're just the Weeknd from XO Records and from Republican. I mean Republican. XO and Republican Records. Not bad album. Starting us off. I mean, he has some mixtapes in a way as well. But never had a studio album coming out until Kissland came about. But that being said, folks, that's one down and four to go. And yes, this will be on my road to Dawn FM. And you're gonna find out on what pertains to the next one I'm gonna do, which is Beauty Behind the Madness, of the songs that I loved. And that ends up being my second favorite album of the Weeknd. Obviously, my first one of all pertains to the Weeknd really step up a notch was After Hours, and because of the iconic image that he brought into the table that he did there. But next one is Beauty Behind the Madness, and I cannot wait to talk about that, and hopefully you'll do the same as well. So that being said, thank you all for watching. For is the artist formerly known as the Natural Born Thriller, and go to your friends about it. Pertains to yours truly, trying to have the best content I can give you. But be sure to tell all your friends about it. You know, which tends to be behind the madness. There's a reason why I keep saying, go tell your friends about it, and you'll find out. So go tell your friends about yours truly, to like, subscribe, and share to anyone else. So once again, we're here on YouTube to try to give you guys the best content that I can give you. So you be well, stay safe, take care of the against going the world, wear your mask, get your hand sanitized, wear your gloves, get vaccinated. But of course, it is your choice and your choice alone. Don't let anyone tell you to get it or not get it. It's your decision at the end of the day. So all you be better, be respectful, be appreciative, to love one another, God bless one another, live in peace and harmony for us all. For I am out here, as I say, peace on the streets. That's all for now. Take care. Excellent.